Hello and welcome. Today we have a look at an old Kiev film camera made in 1968. The camera comes in a protective case and I'm going to try to restore it and see if it's still working. I will use a brush for cameras, a special cleaner for lenses. It doesn't contain alcohol, and a rocket blower and the microfiber cloth. Before cleaning it, I want to have a look at the camera and see if it's in a good condition. Smell test.
Oh yeah, it smells beautiful.
It's hard to describe it, but it has a nice old leather and camera oil smell to it. Unfortunately, the straps were cut off from this camera, but it doesn't really matter. What matters is what's inside. Condition of the camera looks really good, much better than what I was expecting. It just has a bit of dirt on the lens I can see, and I'm not sure if those are scratches on the middle of the lens. We'll try to see if the shutter works and the timer also. If you're new to this channel, click the subscribe button right now and then click the bell icon to get notifications for new videos. The timer and the shutter seem to be working, but we will have to take a closer look at it. Checking the aperture to see if it works and if it has any oil. It seems to be free of oil. Removing the camera from the case is just a matter of unscrewing the tripod mount like this. There seems to be a bit of dirt inside the case, but we will take care of that later. This camera looks really nice to me. It has something special about it. I really like the way it looks like, and if it works, we might even try a few film rolls. When the film is finished, you rewind it with this button. It shows you the way to spin it to put the film back in the cartridge. Not sure what these dials do, but I have a feeling that they are referenced for the ISO speed of the film and to correlate it with the shutter speed. They don't seem to be connected to anything physical on the camera, it just seems to be a reference, but I will check that later and add it in the description. The dial on the right side controls the loading of the film. You load the next frame and press the shutter. To load film or just open the camera, you unlock these two screws. To open it, both of them have to be in the unlock position, like this. Then you can open the camera. Before continuing, I will have a bit of tea right now. The film is loaded on the left side here. You put the cartridge and then you pull it all the way to the right side and put it inside this barrel. And then install the barrel and load the film a few times until it gets to the first position. While turning this dial, you load one frame for the film and prepare the shutter. Have a closer look at how the shutter works. This is really magical. That barrel you saw before just fell on the floor. The sound confirms to us that it's made of metal. Shutter seems to be working properly, and we're gonna have a look at it from the other side of the camera. It looks like it's working perfectly. Let's have another look. Oh, this thing makes me want to go shopping for film now. Only problem with film, in my case, is the processing. I wouldn't want to do the processing at home. I just have to find a lab to do it. It's a Rangefinder camera, and I'm trying to show you the viewfinder, but it's not easy to see. If I want to change the shutter speed, I lift the right dial and move it to the position to indicate the shutter speed I want. The shutter speed can go up to 1250. There is this thing on the top that I'm not sure what it does, but I believe it's a light meter. I don't know if it still works. Write in the comments how you think this should work, because to me it seems like the indicator doesn't really change. But the way it opens and closes, it's really nice. There is a bit of dirt all over the camera, but we will take care of that later. Here is a close-up of the lens front element. I'm not sure if this is just dirt or if there are scratches also. Some of them look like lines, they might be scratches. We'll see how that really is in a moment. The lens is a Jupiter 8M, a 50mm f2, made in 1968 also, the same as the camera. The lens logo tells us this was made by the Arsenal factory in Kiev, Ukraine, formerly Soviet Union. This dial seems to be just a counter for the frames to know how many frames you have left. To remove the lens, you have to press on this small tab, and then the lens will come out like this. Hi having another look at how the shutter works without the lens. All good so far. Taking a closer look at the lens, especially the back element of the lens, trying to see if there is any fungus inside, which there isn't. It has no fungus at all, just some signs that there might be scratches on the front element and also on the back. This one on the back, it looks like definitely it's a scratch. On the right side, you see it there. I'm going to try to clean the lens and see if those scratches are just pieces of dust. The first step is to use the rocket blower to remove any dust particles that can be removed. After that, I will use a microfiber cloth and the optical cleaning solution. I just sprayed twice and I will gently wrap the front element and I will spin it like this, trying not to touch the edges and the middle at the same time. I'm trying not to bring any dirt from the edges into the middle of the lens. Doing the same with the back element and also changing the position of the microfiber cloth just so that any dirt that was gathered on it will not be just spread across the lens again. One final lens wipe and it's time to check it and see who's a scratch and whose was just dirt. Notice the circular motion. Looking closely at the lens now after cleaning it, it looks like all the scratches that I saw before, they were just dust particles and maybe pieces of things from the case. Now the lens is perfectly clean. As you can see, there is nothing on the front element and the back element is also just has no dust, no scratches, except one point that it is an actual scratch. And the scratch, thankfully, it's on the edge of the lens and I'm not sure if that's gonna be a problem. I think it won't really affect the image too much, because it's on the edge. The scratch clearly shows in this point. But except that, the lens is perfect. It has just a bit of dust inside, but thinking that this was made in 1968 and to look like this today, it's a miracle. Now we really must get some film and try this camera and see how it works. The rest of the cleaning is just with the brush, trying to remove any dust from the shutter or around the film area, lifting the shutter a bit to clean any remaining dust. Before using any old film camera, you should check that the light seals are in good condition, and just go around the whole camera and make sure that the light seal is in good shape. If any light goes inside through these light seals, the film can be ruined. Now just reinstalling the case. It's just a reverse like before. I'm trying to figure out how to lock it, but eventually, wait, I forgot one thing. I forgot to put the barrel back. And there it goes again, it fell on the floor. It's for sure metal, this one. Open it up again and put in the barrel in its place. Easiest to do this is with the camera upside down, I just realized, and push it all the way down and somehow find the way to lock these things. The camera must be properly closed when you have film inside, so there are no light leaks ruining your film. Going further with the cleaning, I decided to clean the viewfinders also, the same method with the microfiber cloth and the optical cleaning solution. Brushing off any remaining dust. I should have done this at the beginning, but it's not too late even now. It looks really clean now, just as it should be. To reinstall the lens back on the camera, you just align the red marker on the lens with the red markers on the camera and just do it. Slide it, lock it like this. A note about the focusing is done with this dial and it spins the whole lens. At infinity it locks and you have to pull it a bit to unlock it. Okay, we've cleaned it, we checked it, it really works, it's clean, now it's ready to go. Before installing the camera back into the case, I want to clean the case also, just so that there is no dirt going back into the camera. When you store the camera, close the aperture all the way down and put it to infinity. And sliding it down in the case and locking the tripod mount, it's pretty easy. The good thing about this case is that it helps prevent any light leaks inside the camera. Even if the light seals are not perfect, this will very likely help avoid any damage to the film. Now we can say it's really ready to go, it just needs some film and some free time. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And also, let me know in the comments if you have it and how you use it, if you like it or what's wrong with it, if it has any problems. In the meantime, don't forget to subscribe and I will see you next time.